Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to talk about what it means to use an R group in a molecule. And I confess, when I first learned this topic, and I remember when I first learned it, I had no idea what an R group was, and it confused me to no end. So hopefully you'll have a better understanding than I did when I first learned this topic. So an R group is really a wild card in a molecule. It's where it's much like using an asterisk in a text search. So if you did a search in some text engines for asterisk ball, you might get a lot of different words returned. You might get football, you might get baseball, basketball, oddball, all kinds of words might come back. So that's really how we use an R group in molecules. So let's give an example to try to describe this. Let's say you developed this reaction right here. This reaction that converts one functional group, an alkene, into another functional group, an alkane. And when you develop this reaction works on more than just the starting material that's shown, the molecule shown. It works on lots of things. In fact, you can have almost anything, any carbon group, coming off of this particular carbon. Well, the way we do that is we say, that is an R group. So you can have all kinds of things there. It's just like putting an asterisk there. This reaction works with lots of different R groups. And so if you wanted to run this reaction on this alkene, you would say, oh yeah, that would work. That would give you the alkane. And this is your R group. So in this case, R equals CH2, CH2, CH3. Now, R groups, there are no specific rules on R groups. So we have to bring some assumptions. What do you mean when you write an R group? I'd say the safest interpretation for an R group is that you can replace an R group with an sp3 hybridized carbon group. That's the safest example. What people normally do is R can be any carbon or a hydrogen. This is what most people assume when they see an R group. The least safe is that R can be almost anything. It could be a chlorine, it could be an oxygen, it could be a carbon. This is rarely the case, but sometimes occurs. But this is what we are going to typically assume, that when you say there's an R group there, it could be any carbon or a hydrogen. So this is an R group. It's a wild card. It's a way to specify a broad range of related structures without having to draw all those little structures. As a trivia point, when you put R groups in a molecule, these are called Markush structures. And these are really commonly encountered in a lot of different fields, and particularly they're developed in patent law. So it's kind of an interesting application of chemistry as it applies to legal proceedings. But these are Markush structures. R groups are wild cards in a molecule.